Ladies and gentlemen, here at the beautiful Hyatt Regency Saipan Ballroom, Stella Marianas is proud to present the 2021 Miss Marianas Pageant. Let us welcome our 2019 Miss Marianas, Shannon Satsumoto, and our luminous 2021 Miss Marianas contestants. Are you ready to be legendary?
Contestant number one, Vincent Renuel Licop Robasto. 26, Coblerville. Contestant number 2, Lily Dior Carrillo. 19, Navy Hill.
Contestant number 3, Turami Diet Azuzu Diaz. 19, San Vicente.
Contestant number 4, Naomi Reen Borja Lizama. 21, Dandan.
Contestant number 5, Haani Marie San Nicolas Eugenio. 22, San Roque.
Contestant number 6, Bernadette Horry. 20, Asmatuis.
Contestant number 7, Rochelle Tsunami Ramon. 19, Dan Dan.
Contestant number 8, Savannah Lynn Redlox De Los Santos. 23, Garapan.
Contestant number.
Thank you to our 8 Ultra Luminary 2021 Miss Marianas contestants and our 2019 Miss Marianas Shannon Sasamoto. Good afternoon, Hafaday and Tito. Legends are born when perseverance and passion collide. And today, we honor the hard work, dedication, aspirations, and true grit of a team and a community that continues to show we could rise to epic levels despite the challenges we face and carve out a legendary lifetime experience for our Marianas. The global pandemic has literally brought the world we once knew to a standstill, and the road to recovery has only begun. Yet in all this chaos, the love and support we have received to crown our Marianas' next ambassador continues to be the light and inspiration in all that we do. We are grateful to have had the opportunity to meet and work with 8 extraordinary young women, our 2021 Miss Marianas contestants, Vincent Robasto, Lily Carrillo, Taremi Diaz, Naomi Lazama, Haani Eugenio, Bernadette Horry, Rochelle Ramon, and Savannah De Los Santos. We have had an incredible journey with each of you, filled with exciting activities and workshops, guiding you to be the confident and phenomenal young women we see today. We would like to extend our most heartfelt thank you to our Stellar Marianas as officers, directors, and volunteers for committing your time and energy to ensure the success of this year's pageant. We bow to your passion and kindness in sharing what you know and making all the learning worthwhile. Bringing our Marianas to the global stage is no easy feat. And our luminary heroes who made it all possible are our gracious title, major, and individual sponsors, as well as active community partners who have come together with amazing generosity despite the difficulties and hurdles before us all. The beautiful vision we share for our islands is both exhilarating and aspirational, a testament to hard work we continue to do to make us all proud. As she passes the crown tonight, we would like to thank our 2019 Miss Marianas Shannon Tudela Sasamoto for being a true legendary queen, rising to all challenges before her and leading an inspiring reign that was filled with positivity and passion, leaving an enduring saga for years to come. We wish you success and blessings in all of your future endeavors. Thank you and your family for your support and all that you have accomplished for our islands. To the people of the Marianas, families and friends, your unwavering support allows us to create iconic experiences for our young women. Help our Marianas shine against all odds and weave an epic tale for the world to see. Together, we are ready to be legendary.
There you are, come on in, it's almost time. So I'm trying to find a face mask that will match my outfit. What do you think of this one? Do you think it makes my butt look big? Don't answer that, I have options. I'm trying to find a face mask that's fit for a queen. I really wish Monique was here. She would know. I know what Monique would tell me. Don't ever be afraid to sparkle.
I'm just gonna work this stage a little bit. I saw one girl do this one too. Hop it in, Tiro Wally, how's everyone feeling? Welcome to the most beautiful evening in the entire Pacific. This is the 2021 Miss Marianas Pageant. This year marks our 45th anniversary where we are celebrating beauty throughout the Marianas. And today, I'm gonna have the honor of emceeing with former Miss Marianas queens. This year's theme is the dream girls. These are the kinds of girls that we think about and dream about when we think of paradise. And they are our Miss Marianas contestants. Tonight, I have the honor as well to fulfill one of my biggest dreams, to talk by the spotlight with a girl who probably doesn't know my name. That's okay, because she's super pretty and she's super smart. Let's give them a round of applause. You're gonna get to meet them later. And then now, more importantly tonight, one of our contestants, her dreams is gonna be coming true, where she's gonna be crowned the next Miss Marianas. Let's get a feel. Who you think is gonna be? Hello? Wake up! And now here to give you a snippet of what journey these girls really had gone through to finally get to tonight, here is the Road to the Crown video. Once upon a time, there were eight dream girls on a journey of a lifetime. They stood above 7-inch cliffs and walked and danced the distance. they lit a Christmas village in an array of technicolor. Before going any further, they washed and combed their hair. They learned to eat like a queen. They cooked a feast for their guests. Like any queen, they learned to dance again and to eat again. They worked amongst the people in style. They made the earth green with more trees, made a donation to those in need, and their minds were made free when they learned to love themselves first. Our ladies washed and fixed their hair again to create their cover photos for their fairy tale story. This time, they ate healthier and got even more prettier. They were prepared to fight their way through to continue on this arduous journey. The journey got spicier as they went to Tinian and had fun on the beach. Finally, the night has arrived, as all fairy tales have a happy ending. This is a tale of girls becoming sisters and events becoming memories that will last a lifetime.
A good role model to young girls and other women in my community. A message for myself for this pageant journey is to take it slow and remember not everything needs to be rushed and needs to be perfect, but as long as I'm having fun, because this isn't just a competition, it's also a learning experience. And so to take it all in and be grateful for the opportunity. I never want to go without you next to me. I wouldn't do it differently.
My name is Ha'ani Marie Sinicolas Eugenio, your contestant number 5. I am 21 years old, currently residing in the beautiful village of San Roque. I decided to join this year's pageant to take the opportunity in using this platform to engage with our community. I would love to get more involved with various causes and organizations, and also become a model citizen for our youth. A message to my future self would be, continue this journey with confidence and poise. You are worthy. Stand up for what you believe in, and you can achieve anything you desire. Thank you. Sizos Masi. I never even have to doubt. I never want to go without you next to me. I wouldn't do it differently. When your heart is racing.
Hola and buen día. My name is Lydia Carrillo, and I am 19 years old. I am from the beautiful village of Navy Hill. I joined this year's pageant because as soon as I came to Saipan, I fell in love with the amazing people and culture here. And being in this pageant has already put me in this community in the most incredible and positive way possible. A future message to myself and all of the amazing women I have met during this experience is that no matter what, win or lose, we are all queens. Thank you.
Afades and Tito, my name is Naomi Borja Zama. I'm 21 years old from the village of Dandan, and I joined Miss Marianas because it's definitely a new experience, but through this experience I hope to have a positive influence on our youth because they are our future, but also to support our communities within our islands and meet new people. A message that I often remind myself throughout this journey is to remember that everybody's different and no one's perfect.
Hi everyone, my name is Rochelle Tsunami Ramon and I am 19 years old, currently residing in the village of Dandan. And I joined this year's pageant to gain new experiences, to get out of my comfort zone, and to enjoy myself more while making new friends. And with this great journey ahead, a message that I give myself is to stay positive and to keep my head up high through any challenge that I approach. Thank you. No matter how you're living, setting fire to the place, and the sound to set your soul on fire. The heart is the amplifier. It's all that's required.
Half a day in Tirawomi. My name is Vincent Robasto, your proud contestant number one for Miss Marianas 2021. I am 26 years old, residing in the village of Coblerville. I once instilled this great insight on my mind. The one day when the world is in chaos, I don't want to be able to say, I just stood there and watched. This year, I joined the Miss Marianas pageant because I want to make a difference in multiple aspects. I am an environmental steward myself, although one individual can only do so much. Being involved in an organization that strives for the same goals, we can do a lot more. That's when the real change begins. I am beyond thrilled to pour my heart and soul into serving the 57,000 people of the Northern Mariana Islands in hopes that upon building my experience throughout this journey, I'll have a deeper sense of purpose, strength, and that we would grow together as one. Your growth is my growth, CNMI. Celebrate beauty. Celebrate Marianas. Thank you, and to Zeus Moss.
Half a day. My name is Savannah Lynn De Los Santos, and I am contestant number 8. I am 23 years old from the village of Chinatown. I joined this pageant because I love new adventures, taking risks, and taking on new challenges. I firmly believe that when we take on these new experiences and we feel uncomfortable, that's when we grow the most. This pageant just offered so many opportunities to experience that growth, including getting more involved in the community, growing as an individual person and as a young woman, and just meeting so many beautiful souls and kind hearts. And if I could give myself a message ongoing this journey, I would tell myself that you're doing great. To laugh as much as you can, to crack all those jokes that you have, to be the reason that someone smiles whenever they meet you or whenever you come across them, and to really just enjoy the moments and stay present and have fun. Thank you.
Wow, our dream girls really had a big adventure on their journey to the crown. They got involved in some community outreaches, personal training, and even a fabulous boat ride to our neighboring islands of Tinian and Manugaha. Shucks, I should have been there with them. Dang. So they definitely know what it took to get this far into the competition. Up next, here for a special performance, here to perform Otea, which is a traditional dance from Tahiti. It is a rapid hip shaking and a dramatized gesture, reenacting the daily occupations of life. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Te'ivi Maori.
Thank you.
thank you to Evie Maori for that shaking of a performance. Ladies and gentlemen, we continue on with our show. Please help me in welcoming my very first co-MC queen. Let's welcome to the stage the tantalizing 2004 Miss Marianas, Tracy Del Rosario. Ooh. Let's blow kisses and hugs, Tracy, from afar. Love, love, love. Hi, Tracy. Welcome to the show and welcome to everybody else. Doesn't she look amazing? Yes.
Thank you so much for having me. I am so honored to be here to join this marvelous event.
Yes, I'm we're so, so excited to have you. So, Tracy, we would like to know, like, what have you been up to since being crowned Miss Marianas?
Professionally, I have been a special education teacher for the last 9 years at Hopwood Middle School. Ooh. During my spare time, my family and I like to do charity work in our community by providing food and aid to community members in need. It's been a wonderful experience so far and truly honored to be here.
Wow, definitely. Really service at its best. Yeah, round of applause. That's awesome. Okay, so Tracy, the competition has already started and we're getting closer. Not that close yet, but we're getting closer to finding out who the next Miss Marianas is going to be. Yes. So from one sister queen to another, right, what advice would you give to the next Miss Marianas?
Wonderful. My advice to my next sister queen is serve your community with compassion. Serve as if it is your last day on earth, because every queen radiates beauty in all that they do. Thank you.
Yeah, definitely. Ooh, see, spoken like a true queen. Service, right? Definitely, yes. Service is at the forefront of what Miss Marianas does. And I think definitely during this pandemic time, right, that we all kind of are looking for that role model, that person who's advocating for those who don't have a voice. So that's really awesome.
Thank you.
Okay, so we're about to enter into the first segment of the competition, which is going to be the National Costume Competition, right? Yeah, but I'm back there. I'm seeing a lot of colors. Maybe a couple of things I should not see, but it's beautiful, right? It's beautiful. So Tracy, what was your experience kind of in your national costume competition?
My national costume competition was a saint that honored flowers. Ooh. And my top was a floral bouquet. I had a headpiece that radiates the sunlight and a huge skirt gown at the bottom part.
Oh, beautiful. Yes. Definitely representing our indigenous flora and fauna.
Yes, we can see our saint florals.
So was she kind of like, were you like Aphrodite, where you did like some poses on stage? You're like, oh, don't look at this. Or, you know.
She was a floral Aphrodite.
A very local Aphrodite for sure. Nice. Okay, so let's get ready for the 2021 Miss Marianas National Costume Competition. As I said earlier, this part is going to be big and flashy. Please protect your eyes from excessive glitter, which might come your way. So each of our dream contestants were asked to create a costume that represents what the Marianas means to them, allowing for creativity and showmanship. And so it begins. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2021 Miss Marianas contestants in the National Costume Competition.
Introducing contestant number one, Vincent Licob Rabasso. This vibrant, phenomenal costume was made by Filipino designer Benj Legaspi. During an expedition in the Marianas Trench, the Marianas snailfish was discovered at a depth of 27,000 feet. The Marianas snailfish is the deepest creature ever caught in the Mariana Trench, with its depth making it one of the deadliest places on the planet. She has also been fascinated by the deep blue ocean and the underwater world full of mystery and immense possibilities that lie beneath. She wanted to bring to surface the deepest yet truly captivating creature and allow it to be visible to the human eye. Vincent has chosen to represent the Marianas snailfish due to its strength, resiliency, and its beauty. The Marianas snailfish not only survives but lives in the deep dark water where sunlight hasn't hit in a billion years. Despite all the immense pressure and sub-zero temperatures, the snailfish survives. The majestic color blue represents the Marianas Trench and the depth of its water. The color red symbolizes its strength and resiliency. Its mysterious yet elegant beauty is represented by the color purple. The crown headpiece symbolizes the creature's rightful and deserving claim as the most powerful species with its outstanding durability. Though despite the harsh environment it lives in, the Mariana snailfish not only thrives under these conditions, but their bodies have also adapted to help them live under high pressure, thus also having bioluminescence qualities which allows the creatures to make their own light in a dark world. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Vincent Lico Rabasto.
Introducing contestant number two, Lily Dior Carrillo. Her national costume is a state bird of the sea and the Amai, the Marianas fruit dove, also known as Ipaluman Totor. This bird is one of the most beautiful indigenous birds that soar above the Mariana Islands. The Totor has bright, beautiful colors that each represent an indigenous part of Saipan. The fiery orange represents showcases the passion and drive for our community. We as a community have endured through tough times, and she hopes to keep that alive. The proud purple worn on the dove's chest is an example of the kindness and compassion our people possess for each other. The green on the feathers are the island's flora and fauna, the incredible vegetation that encompasses Saipan. And the blue represents our oceans and skies. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Lily Dior Carrillo.
Introducing contestant number three, Toremi Azuzu Diaz. The Palaxy or parrotfish is significant to our marine culture. There is a symbiotic relationship between the parrotfish and the coral. The parrotfish spends 90% of its day cleaning the reef of algae. This helps the coral grow and thrive, which in turn provides food for our people. The Palaxy is known as the doctor of reef. Just like the parrotfish, she is determined to help our people and islands as much as she can. The blue headpiece, adorned with gold beads, symbolizes the light that shines on our people. The blue fins that flutter on her side represent the direction our people and islands go towards. Forward. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Toremi Azuzu Diaz.
Introducing contestant number four, Naomi Borja Lizama. She is the goddess Osos. The headpiece, earrings, ligature, and gill are all made of beads and fishing line. The headpiece is a replica of the cultural moire. This represents the fragrance of joy and peace that surrounds each and every one of us. The ligaturu is a wide necklace handmade of beads that is worn across the chest. This symbolizes the armor of pride that each of us possess for these islands we call home. The gill is a belt made of beads that is often worn as an accessory for defense against illness. Throughout all the trials we have faced, we will continue to be courageous against it again and again. All Rithbalawash beadwork are unique to the Marianas. These stunning beads are used for special occasions such as weddings, funerals, and a ceremony for a queen. Instead of gold and silver, we adorn ourselves with beautiful and vibrant beads that showcases our traditions, heritage, and proud Rithbalawash culture. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Naomi Borja Lizama.
Introducing contestant number 5, Ha'ani San Nicolas Eugenio. Our Commonwealth owes its life to the goddess of fire. Without her volcanoes, the Sinamai would not exist. Her national costume is the volcano goddess. The deep blue of the skirt and the opening split represent the goddess herself emerging from the Pacific Ocean to give life to our precious islands. In the gold overlay, we see her initial formation of our islands. The trickling red fabric not only represents the lava that grew and hardened to rock, but also symbolizes the manifestation of the life and light that eventually was born and able to flourish into our present-day islands. Fire is life and energy. From her gray ashes grew flora and fauna, ever present today in our forests and jungles. The eruption of lava showcased at the top of the dress symbolizes the fire and warmth embedded in each of us. The eruptive and vibrant headpiece not only demonstrates the physical birth of our Sinamai, but symbolizes the fierceness and passionate nature of the people who call these islands home. Just as she has parted the rough seas, the people of the Sinamai too prevent against their odds. The spear she carries reminds her people to rise. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Ha'ani San Nicolas Eugenio.
Introducing contestant number 6, Bernadette Horry. Her costume represents her love for spice, not just in food, but in life. She is depicting the spice that brings to the lives of her friends, family, and the people she comes across. She is the hot pepper, better known in the Marianas as the Dunny. She adds Dunny to all her favorite dishes. Dunny is the kick in life that we all need. Make your favorite dish flavorful by adding Dunny. The vibrant red symbolizes the heat of the Marianas and resilience of its people. The green on her costume represents the stem of the pepper tree, but it also represents growth and the promise of new beginnings. This contestant has a fiery spirit and passion that she brings to everything she does. Just like the Dunny, she likes to bring the heat. The spirit of the Marianas and her people inspires her every day. She is fiery, confident, resilient. Here is Bernadette Horry!
Introducing contestant number 7, Rochelle Tsunami Ramon. Here is the goddess of healing. She is dressed as the Noni tree. This plant is used medicinally, recreationally, and for dietary purposes. She chose this indigenous plant to represent her home, her traditions, and most especially, her mom, a very special person in her life that she wants to dedicate this costume to. Thank you, Mom, for always teaching your culture's customs, beliefs, and traditions. Growing up, anyone who was feeling sick or in pain, her mom would prepare the noni fruit or leaves as medicine. In an instant, healing takes place. From its roots, stem, leaves, flowers, and fruits, each part of the tree is used purposefully to heal and cure almost any ailment. The green represents the beautiful life that nature provides for our islands and our people. Brown represents the roots of our island's cultures, along with its costumes, beliefs, and traditions that are strongly held. The colors of the fruits used and green, which represents love through healing, just as her mom did when using the plant to heal. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Rochelle Tsunami Ramon.
Introducing contestant number 8, Savannah Relox de los Santos. Emerging from within the deepest heart of the Pacific Ocean, she is the creator of the Mariana Islands and protector of our waters, our islands, and our people. She is our guardian goddess of the Marianas Trench. Just as the dynamic shifting plates of the Marianas Trench is responsible for the creation of our island chain, so is this goddess responsible for creating and nurturing an environment that is hashtag Marianas Strong. Savannah's first advocacy is speaking out to the silence surrounding mental health. She strongly believes in creating and nurturing a safe space for the people of the Marianas to be their most authentic selves. She says sharing your authenticity is the most transformational gift you can give to the world. Her second advocacy is addressing the injustice of domestic violence in our community. Just as the Marianas Trench provides a safe habitat to a diverse and thriving ecosystem, so does this goddess protect our waters, our islands, and most especially, her people. As a witness in a household of domestic violence, she believes that speaking up and bringing awareness to this prevalent issue will help protect many, not only in our community, but also the world. Savannah embodies resilience. She has a fighting spirit and believes to always protect and serve our people. The colors of her costume convey the brilliant blues of our waters. The fins represent the distinctive sea life unique to our reefs and safeguarded deep in the Marianas Trench. The pearls paint the Marianas as a hidden gem within the Pacific. Her love for the Marianas runs deeper and wider than the Marianas Trench. She is grand, she is bold, she is fierce, she is like no other. Here is Savannah Relox de los Santos.
Let's welcome back our sparkling contestants for a final look in the national costume competition.
Let's make some noise. Wow, what a stunning presentation! Let's give our ladies another round of applause. Thank you, ladies, for sharing your glamorous designs and love for the Marianas. Didn't we see that? Anybody in the front complaining about glitter or you're good? Yes? Wow, Tracy. I felt like I had a whole end of my history lesson, right? We learned about a snailfish. I didn't even know we had a snailfish.
It was truly amazing.
Yeah.
Very vibrant, colorful, exciting.
Beautiful. Yeah,
just
they totally
wonderful.
Represented the whole array of the our history, our culture, and kind of also the diversity of our people, yes, right, that live within the Marianas.
The beauty of the Marianas, ladies and gentlemen.
That's awesome. You know, honestly, though, those costumes reminded me of the quenching cocktails of Bacardi, Grey Goose, and Maker's Mark being served right over there by Marpak. Yeah, that's your cue. You know, get the wallet out and let's enjoy the night. But, oh my goodness, can we give my co-MC queen another round of applause? Didn't she do amazing?
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you, Tracy, for being here. And ladies and gentlemen, the tantalizing 2004 Miss Marianas, Tracy Del Rosario. Beautiful. There's definitely more queens coming your way. Our next performance of the evening is no stranger to the Marianas stage. She first performed in the 2014 Miss Marianas, where she amazed everyone with her powerful voice. Honestly, be prepared to be amazed. She also is the most recent winner of the CNMI's Got Talent competition. She is definitely a star to watch out for. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a round of applause for Bernice Sabino singing Dandelion.
All of the time.
Oh my gosh, a round of applause for Bernice Sabito. Good job.
Thank you so much.
Wow. Powerful voice and just such a small body. I wish they could say the same thing about me, but I'm in reverse. Nice. Up next, we have a very special presentation where our 2019 Miss Marianas, Shannon Sasamoto, had held a virtual national costume competition on our Instagram. And we're about to show you who that winner is. In addition to that, no one knows the beauty and love of the Marianas and her people other than the Marianas Visitors Bureau. Here is a spirited message right here from home. Enjoy.
Oh,
representing and loving our islands the best. And as well, we like to mention the winner of that Instagram National Costume Competition was the designer, Joseph Ada. He wasn't the model, but he designed the clothes that was on the model. But you know what? I'm also available too. I can model a little bit. You know, remember you saw my leg just over there. Wow, what an amazing thing. I just realized that in order for us to continue on with the show, would everyone please join me in welcoming my next guest MC queen. Please welcome to the stage the joyous 2001 Miss Marianas Janet King. I love that. Hi, Jan. Oh, yes. Air kisses. Maybe also I want to try this one. I've always wanted to see this one. I saw this on YouTube once. Oh, you caught it. Abhinay, Janet, welcome to the show.
It is great to be here. Awesome. Now you can hear me.
Yes, nice. So, Janet, we would also like to know, what have you been doing since being crowned Miss Marianas since 2001.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's been 20 years. I do have to say before I answer that it's very important for me to note that I represented the island of Tinian when I entered the pageant.
Oh, make some noise for Tinian!
And then, of course, after being crowned Miss Marianas Universe, I represented the entire Marianas. Since then, I went on to get my law degree, and I have been practicing law for 14 years now. I've been admitted to practice law in the state of Hawaii, Guam, and of course, our home, the Northern Marianas. But most of all, Romalor, I am mommy to Aww. Kate and Sam.
Wow. Okay, so first, I have two questions. One, do you like spice being a Tinian girl?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah.
Of course,
Donnie. Okay, then my second question is, do your kids know that you are a former queen?
You know, my two kids, Sammy is 6 and Katie is going to be 10. They know me only as mommy.
Oh, you don't want to make them call you Your Majesty?
Oh, not yet until I pay their college tuition.
Yeah. Nice. What type of message or what advice would you like to impart upon your children, right? And also definitely all children in the Marianas.
That is a really good question. To my son, Samuel, he is 6. I want him to know that a woman is someone who is beautiful on the inside as well as the outside. And for my daughter Kate, I want her to know and truly believe that anyone, whether a man or a woman, can do anything in this world as long as they have education and they set their mind to what they want to do.
Man, that's awesome. Let's give a round of applause to mommy. Wow. Okay, so we're getting closer to crowning the next Miss Marianas as a former queen, right, and a sister queen to this next one that's going to be crowned. What advice would you give to the next Miss Marianas?
That's another good question.
I promise it's not the Q&A portion.
Well, you know, I look at this logo and we see a star. It doesn't just twinkle. Each of these ladies backstage, they shine brilliantly. But to the one who finally gets crowned, I say to her, you have a unique opportunity and a responsibility to showcase beauty, the beauty that is within you, the unique you, as well as the beauty of all the islands. And so that would be my message.
That's awesome. I wish we could get another crown for you again. Just put it on your head.
It's been 20 years. I got practice.
Okay, so Janet, we already saw an amazing presentation from our contestants in the National Costume Competition. Then this definitely makes the job of being a selection panelist the hardest job in the room.
Hard and probably fun. Aren't you all having fun?
Yeah. So would you please join me in introducing our selection panel, the people who will determine the next Miss Marianas.
Of course. Let's meet our first panelist. She was the first runner-up in the 1997 Miss Marianas pageant. She is the founder and president of the nonprofit organization Lady Diane Torres Foundation, and with the help of generous partners, established numerous programs that bring together children and families to get involved. And she is a proud sponsor of Stellar Marianas and numerous nonprofits that bring out the best of our people and our islands. She helped establish the Women Recognition Program under the CNMI Women's Affairs Office. And this year's theme is 2021 Women in Music. The foundation is excited for the release of its sixth children's book, written by young authors under the CNMI Girl Scouts program. Our panelist holds a master's degree in education and was a longtime educator in the CNMI public school system. She is the loving wife of our honorable governor, Ralph De Leon Guerrero Torres, and she's the proud mother of their six children. Welcome, First Lady Diana Tudela Torres.
Welcome. Nice. Our next panelist, she was her class valedictorian for the Northern Marianas Academy in 2013. She continued her studies at the Northern Marianas College and graduated at the top of her class in the nursing program in 2016. She holds a graduate degree as a midwife nurse. She has been a registered nurse at the Commonwealth Health Corps Corporation, assisting women and their families in labor, birth, and postpartum for 3.5 years. That's a lot of babies. After becoming a certified nurse midwife, she plans to stay in the Marianas and continue to care for women through their pregnancy, childbirth, gynecologic, and reproductive health. Her passion for contributing to the health of our people began when she was crowned Miss Marianas in 2016. She used her platform to start a Mother's Day event entitled Run for Mom, and later introduced this program as an annual event in the Women's Health Month. Hashtag begin with me. She represented the Marianas in the Miss International pageant and placed second in the Miss International's People's Choice Award. And she is the proud daughter and former queen of the Marianas. Welcome, Peachy Josephine Kitigua.
Our next panelist is currently employed with the CNMI public school system under the Personal Responsibility Education Program, as well as the Sexual Risk Advanced Education Program. He served as the National Director for Stellar Marianas from 2014 to 2019. His alter ego, Eris, represented the Northern Marianas in the Queen of Queens pageant. Ooh. And placed second runner-up in 2006. His passion and expertise in the world of pageantry radiates through the title holders that have represented the Northern Marianas since 2002. He has accompanied many of our queens to various competition locations in Guam, here in the United States, in the mainland, and in countries like Japan and Venezuela. He is proud to have represented and served our islands in that capacity throughout the world. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Crispin Ping De Leon Guerrero Jr.
Ooh, nice. Our next panelist, she's the executive director of the Tan Shu Lin Foundation, the charitable arm of Tan Holdings. She oversees the foundation's daily operations, including providing support to various community events and projects in the Marianas. She spearheads programs that promote women empowerment and youth development. She's also the executive director and treasurer of the Pacific Century Fellows Marianas Chapter, a development program that offers leadership learning opportunities and experiences to the NMI's potential leaders. She is a very active member of the NMI sports community as she serves as president of both the Kanoa Football Club and the Northern Marianas Badminton Association and director of the Saipan Soccer School. She also has affiliations with international sports federations. She holds a Bachelor's of Science degree in Business Administration, majored in Accounting from Holy Angel University in the Philippines, and a graduate of Management Development Program from the Asian Institute of Management. Welcome, Merle Tolentino.
Our final panelist. She holds a Master's degree in Business Administration and Management, with a concentration in marketing and advertising. She found her knack in advertising and marketing when she worked with a professional portfolio of A-list clients in the sports and beverage market, such as Red Bull, Rockstar, and Neutral Lifestyle Drinks, just to name a few. After being away from home for 15 years, she returned to Saipan to fulfill her commitment to contribute to Saipan's development. She led the marketing and public relations department of Hyatt Regency Saipan. She is currently the marketing director for Triple J Saipan and all CNMI affiliates with several major operations, including Triple J Motors and Payless Superfresh and Truckload Store. She also oversees the marketing of the Triple J restaurant groups and hotels and lodges, which are owned and operated by Triple J Enterprises. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome our final panelist, Maria Valentina Haberman.
Ooh, welcome. And another group of people with a very important job are our official tabulators for tonight, who are David Berger, James Comer, and J. Scott Magliari, also known as BCM. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for our 2021 Miss Marianas official tabulators, BCM! Thank you for being here, and definitely good luck to putting all those numbers down. Like, oh my God, all that energy, I'm pushing it your way.
And who said accountants never have fun?
Yeah, exactly. And they're here. That's awesome. So, Janet, as you mentioned earlier, that this year marks your 20th anniversary as queen. Yeah. Doesn't she look amazing after 20 years? Woo, wow. So we're about to enter into the swimsuit competition. First, two questions. One, do you have experience wearing swimwear? And then two, what advice do you want to give the girls backstage before entering it?
Romolo, I never go anywhere without a swimsuit. It's a given with all the beautiful beaches in the Marianas, of course.
A true island girl, island queen.
Thank you. And to the ladies backstage, you know, the swimsuit competition is always the most nerve-wracking. So people in the audience, all our audience on Facebook Live, please give them a lot of encouragement, a lot of love, so that they'll be reminded that it's about fun and excitement.
Yes, definitely. I love that. And so, ladies and gentlemen, the time has come for one of the most courageous rounds of the competition tonight. Let our dreams come to life as our dreamy contestants compete in the swimsuit competition. And definitely, we'd like to give a huge thank you to Penthouse Boutique for the fiery swimwear. And so, ladies and gentlemen, it begins. The 2021 Miss Marianas Swimsuit Competition. Let's begin with our first two dream girls.
Here we go, come on. They can see us coming from a mile away. They wanna see us, wanna be us, now we don't play. Getting fancy, as you can see, we got a groove making you move, now come on, get on your feet. It's like one, two, what's the move? I got two, three, follow me.
Introducing contestant number one and contestant number two. Beginning with Vincent Licoprabasto.
Right now, get up.
Contestant number one, Vincent Licoprabasto. And now, Lily Dior Carrillo. Contestant number two, Lily Dior Carrillo. Thank you, Vincent and Lily.
Let's continue with another pair of dream girls.
Like this.
Let's meet contestant number three and contestant number four. Contestant number five and contestant number six. Beginning with Ha'ani San Nicolas Eugenio.
This.
Hey. here is contestant number five, Haani San Nicolas Eugenio. And now, Bernadette Horry. Here is contestant number six, Bernadette Horry. Thank you, Haani and Bernadette.
We continue with our final pair of dream girls. Contestant number seven and contestant number eight. Rochelle Tsunami Ramon. Number seven. Do it like this. Yeah. And now Savannah Relux de los Santos. Savannah Relux de los Santos. Thank you, Rochelle and Savannah.
What did you think of that, Marianas? Do you want more? Wait, you really do? Let's make some noise! Let's welcome back all our dazzling contestants in the swimsuit competition. Let's set this house on fire! Wow, what a fierce performance! Thank you, ladies, for that flaming performance in the swimsuit competition! Let's give another round of applause! Wow, woo! That was a lot. I really felt like I was on the beach in the mid of July.
Well, I really want to thank everyone. You made it really exciting with all your applause and your energy. The ladies really do feel it.
Give a round of applause to yourselves for being an amazing audience. Really, truly the best. Man, honestly, that performance made me think of Michelob Ultra or a Bud Light Seltzer. These drinks being served right now are low in calories. We promise you, you ain't gonna gain weight in this show. So honestly, Janet, what did you think of that competition?
You know, it was amazing. And did you think they had fun? Because the smiles were spectacular.
Yeah, man, they made it look so exciting. I honestly thought I really wanted to join that part of the competition, but I'm not really wearing a bikini under this.
But you look good in red.
Oh, thank you for noticing. Hey, Dave, give me a round of applause. This is totally unplanned. So, thank you, Janet, so much for being here. Ladies and gentlemen, can you please give Miss Janet King a round of applause? A queen, as always. Thank you. So, ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our third round of competition. Our ladies had competed in three events earlier. They competed, one, in the personal interview competition, the national costume competition, and now the swimsuit competition. And because we have traveled through those different realms, we need to wake up temporarily from this dream. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing our intermission performance, the Saipan Music and Dance Studio. Founded in 2010, this dance group consists of talented youth from Saipan. They participated in the international hip-hop competition in 2016 and 2018. They represented our CNMI flag to show the world that our islands can compete in the field of dancing. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome to the stage the Saipan Music and Dance Studio. And definitely, cool down with that drink.
Your mamas are not here to take care of you now.
Hit me!
Toffee, coffee, hate me.
Think they freak this like we do, but no, they.
Deep in your eyes, I touch on you more and more every time.
Yeah.
Cause
yeah.
I know I don't understand just how you love you doing, no one else can.
Let's take some calls from the request line. Calling number one.
Hey, man, what's up? This is Dominique from Shady Notes.
I see. Eight figure, that's my type.
That's my type.
Brand new whip, right around dips. I can see why all these basic pissed. Said I want your man, know the fuck I don't fit. He a rich, but he still hitting lick. Spinning bread, but he still can't hit. Please, Lamborghini keys. Dripping ice, he gets flown out to me. Please, I want a man with the beat. From the bag, I'm dumb on a D.
On my lips, take a little sip, privacy on the door.
my type, nigga. That's my type.
Don't never stop if you wanna be on top.
I'm defeated. I got a reason. Doing. I can't stop my body from moving. I'm popping and popping to the music. He's watching me and he's about to lose it. I'm dropping it hotter than the drawer of the smoothie. Tip down and up on some. I'm out of control with it. Dip it low, pick it up slow, poke it out narrow with it. I'm up showing, but it's where my shoes go with it. Now all I need is a room with a pool in it. See, I look good and I'm knowing it. And I was never too proud to be showing it. Say, I look too good for this necklace. And I look too good to be wearing this. You know I look way too good to be innocent. I'm conceited. I got a reason.
Cha-ching!
Come on, y'all. We gotta do the thing.
Ooh, it's something about, just something about the way she moves. I can't figure it out. It's something about her. Cause she walk like a boss, talk like a boss. Manicure and nails, just like the pedicure wrong.
Baby, yeah.
I got a question for you. Is
it worth it? Real love, do you think you deserve it? Cut them off, go and find your purpose and get you a nigga that's solid. Personally, I'll do more than support your dreams, baby. Get you and me. It's time to boss up. Fix your credit, girl, get at it. Get your bag up. Hit that gym and get back fine. Go get that degree. Go, girl, focus on me. Unlock potential that you didn't know you had in you. Know that.
Sometimes I don't know. Ooh, I like it when you turn me on. Ooh, I like it when my body gets down, down, down. I don't even know what I'm thinking. Pierdo mi mente entre toda la gente. Manos por arriba in the club. Everybody yelling at the DJ, turn it up now. I don't even know what to say. Oh, hey. Sweat. Capitan, oh no. I could be your dancing queen. You could be mi rey y mi papi. I could be the one you like. You could be my capitan, oh no.
Yeah, we need that, we need that.
Wow, thank you, the Saipan Music and Dance Studio. Hey, you notice my outfit change? James Bond, what? Hello? I haven't met Romolo. Welcome back to the 2021 Miss Marianas Pageant. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome my very next guest, Queen MC. Here is the Knockout 2003 Miss Marianas Kimberly Rages Manglotnia. Wow! Beautiful! Shucks, I should have kept my red bow tie, Kim.
You should have, yes.
Nice. Hi, welcome, Kim, to the show. So we all want to find out, what have you been doing since being crowned Miss Marianas?
Well, currently, I'm a school counselor at Marianas High School.
Oh,
yes.
Dolphins represent.
Yes, I assist my students with academic counseling, college and career counseling, and social-emotional counseling. And can I just add that it's been such a pleasure and an honor to be working with our youth, to really just be a part of their support system and to help them plan for their futures.
Wow, that's awesome. Thank you so much. Like, what a huge responsibility as well. And I bet, oh my gosh, I bet you do it so beautifully. Like, you look amazing, but you haven't aged since.
Oh, thank you. Neither have you.
Oh, thank you. I kind of felt like a little bit like 10 minutes ago, but yeah. So, Kimberly, we're getting closer to crowning Miss Marianas, right? From one sister queen to another, what advice would you give to the next Miss Marianas?
My advice would be to find something that you're passionate about and to do it wholeheartedly. And that's something that I feel like I've done with my counseling career. I love that each of the girls have their own personal platforms, and I encourage them to really go with it and see it through, because they each have the ability to really make a difference.
Wow, that's awesome. So now we're about to be entering into the fourth segment of the competition. Our contestants are going to pull out all the works in this dream, right?
I'm
Elegance,
excited.
Beauty to the T. What advice would you like to give our contestants backstage before entering the next segment?
Really just come out with confidence and grace. I've been watching the show backstage the entire time, and they are so lovely. They've been doing a great job.
Yeah, definitely. What was your experience, though, in your evening gown competition?
It's been a while, Rome. Well, I do remember coming out feeling very confident and very beautiful. I think my hairdresser did a really good job dolling me up.
Ooh, let's give her a round of applause. Isn't she beautiful?
Thank you.
I think we went to the same hairdresser.
Possibly, yes.
You were the 4 o'clock, right?
Yes. Okay,
exactly. Yeah.
Yes. But I also remember feeling very empowered by all the women around me, my pageant sisters, and by the way, Rome, it's Women's Month.
Wow! Happy Women's Month to the women in the audience.
Yes.
Actually, you know what? Let's do something in here. If you are not a woman in this room, please turn to the closest woman next to you and say, thank you for everything you do. Oh my gosh.
So nice.
I think we just hooked up a lot of people. I think they found the love of their lives tonight right now.
Bro, you didn't tell me thank you.
Thank you, Kimberly, for everything you do. You are an amazing woman. Okay, what about me?
Are you a woman?
Is there such a thing as Men's Month? When is that coming? Nice. So ladies and gentlemen, we are looking into the spotlight and into the most elegant part of our dream. We are about to enter into the evening gown competition.
In the evening gown competition,
Contestants will be judged based on a contestant's presentation of self-confidence, her elegance, and her beauty. Let's prepare to walk through a sparkling evening with our dream girls.
Let the elegance begin in the 2021 Miss Marianas Evening Gown Competition. Get ready for this. Presenting Lily Dior Carrillo.
My favorite people miss my place. Some people run away. way. So people guaranteed, so people love it, but they lie to feel new things. Hey, this don't really matter, it's okay. Love, you're scaring me with everything I don't know. Is you gonna be a memory? I know, I know this all before. I looked at you a different view. That isn't local lore. This
for me, Azuzu.
It's better when together we do more things. Like suddenly I'm moving in my own ways. I know this all before. I looked at you a different view. I thought I knew for sure. Oh, wow. One time, just stay new to you. If the world goes by, I stay new to you. If some girls go by, I stay new to you. Yes, they know. Stay true to you. When the world goes by, it's stay true to you. Bet your love don't
presenting Tormi Azuzu Diaz.
Some people rather wait, some people rather say, some people rather leave the whole wide world than say I leave my people. In a way I lose myself. It's harder to the water to I know I'm doing well, yeah. Some people run away.
Naomi Borja Lizama. Presenting Naomi Borja Lizama.
Ha'ani San Nicolas Eugenio.
Some people rather wait, some people rather say, some people rather leave the whole wide world than say. Favorite people miss my place. Some people run away, some people guaranteed, some people love it, but they lie to feel new things. This don't really matter, it's okay. Love, you're scaring me with everything I don't know. Is you gonna be a memory? I know. I know this all before. I looked at you a different view that isn't local. It's a long time. It's better when together we do more things. Like suddenly I'm moving in my own ways. I knew this all before. I looked at you a different view. I thought I knew for sure. Oh wow. One time, just stay new to you. If the world goes by, I stay new to you. If some girls go by, I stay new to you. Yes, they know. Stay true to you. When the world goes by, it's stay true to you. Bet your luck don't lie, it's stay true to you. Stay true to you.
Presenting Ha'ani San Nicolas Eugenio.
Say I leave my people, in a way I lose myself. It's harder to the water to, I know I'm doing well, yeah. Some people run away, some people guaranteed, some
Bernadette Horry. Presenting Bernadette Horry.
that you a different view. That isn't local or this alone. It's better when together we do more things. But suddenly I'm moving in my own ways. I knew this all before. I looked at you a different view.
Regency, Savannah, Relox de los Santos.
If the world goes by, it's there new to you. If some girls go by, it's there new to you. Yes, they know. Don't lie, I'm just there true to you. When the world goes by, it's there new to you.
Let's welcome back all our Miss Marianas contestants for a final look in the evening gown competition.
Some people rather say, some people rather leave the whole wide world than say I leave my people. In a way I lose myself. It's harder to the water to I know I'm doing well, yeah. Some people run away, some people guaranteed. Some people love it with their lie to feel no things. I'll be here for my brothers in the end, yeah. Oh, it's rather late, so. But the one thing's for sure, yeah. And if you know to you, if you know to you, then trust, it's rather late, cross. But the one thing's for sure, yeah. And just stay true to you, just stay true to you. Time, just stay new to you. If the world goes by, it's stay new to you. If some girls go by, it's stay new to you. Yes, they know. Don't lie, just stay true to you. When the world goes by, it's stay
new. Wow, ladies, what an elegant performance. What did you think of that presentation?
Gosh, they were all so breathtaking.
Man, gorgeous. Let's give her another contestant a beautiful round of applause.
Great job, girls. You're all winners.
Well, thank you, Kimberly Rages Mangonia, for being here and gracing us with your presence. Let's give another round of applause to Miss Marianas, Kimberly Mangonia.
Thank you.
And so the show continues. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming my next guest queen, the youthful 2014 Miss Idaho USA, Yvette De Leon Guerrero Bennett. There she is. Hi, Yvette, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, so we're about to enter directly into the question and answer portion of the competition. Any advice for our ladies here on stage before entering that?
Of course. First, just breathe. Inhale, exhale, ladies. You got this. And one advice that I would love to give them is the three C's, which was the advice I received, was first, clarity, going straight to the point, consistency, staying on topic, and three, confidence, icing on the cake.
Ooh, let's do this, ladies. I like that. Confidence. Nice. So the Q&A is a big portion of the scoring because Miss Marianas has to be able to think on her feet during her many public appearances and be our Marianas ambassador on the international stage. Each lady will have 60 seconds to answer her question. So ladies, let's all just take a deep breath and enjoy and believe in yourself. You got this. Okay. Are we ready for Q&A? And so, can we please get the magic bowl?
Yes.
Thank you, VP. And we begin with Vincent Lecop Robasto.
And I'll repeat your question twice. How would you encourage more volunteerism in our community once more?
how would you encourage more volunteerism in our community?
Thank you for that question.
You're welcome.
As human beings, we are different in multiple ways in terms of mindset, perspective, and personality. In order to truly encourage people in our community to volunteer, we must lead by example. In order for us to fully encourage people in our community to lead, for us to lead by example. Sorry, I'm so nervous. An act of volunteerism isn't just measured by the service that is given or the time we give, but by it coming genuinely from our hearts. Thank you.
Thank you, Vincent.
Up next, let's hear from Lily Dior Carrillo. Hi, Lily. How are you?
I'm amazing. Thank you. How are you?
I'm doing good. You know, I'm excited. You're all in beautiful gowns, right?
Thank you.
Let's see it. Pick your question, please.
I can open it.
All right.
I'm trying to, like, you know, balance a lot. I'm trying to impress. You know, it's Women's Month, so I'm trying to claim a men's month.
You're doing great.
Okay. So here's your question. What Chamorro or Carolinian song inspires you and why? One more time. What Chamorro or Carolinian song inspires you and why?
Thank you. My personally favorite Chamorro or Carolinian song would have to be Better Way by Love and Half a Day. It's inspirational in the way that it speaks on how a new day has new beginnings and how every day we can be better than the day before. And that's why it has to be my favorite Chamorro or Carolinian song. Thank you.
Thank you, Lily.
Next, we have Tormi Azuzu Diaz. Hey, Tormi, if you can go and pick a question for us. Tormi, if you could speak to one of our Marianas legendary characters, who would it be and what would you say to him or her? Once more, if you could speak to one of our Marianas legendary characters, who would it be and what would you say to him or her?
Thank you for that question.
You're welcome.
One of my favorite legendary characters would be Sirena, and I would ask her to change me to be a mermaid for one day to explore the mysteries of what the ocean holds and just to explore the rest of the islands. Thank you.
Thank you, Tormi.
Up next, let's hear from Naomi Borja Lizama. Hi, Naomi, how are you?
Doing well, thank you, how are you?
I'm doing great too, thank you so much for asking. Please pick from this beautiful bowl.
Okay, I'll do it. Okay, here is your question.
What traditions in our Marianas culture do you most admire and why? One more time. What traditions in our Marianas culture do you most admire and why?
Thank you, Romolo, for that question. A Marianas tradition that I admire the most would be called the blessings of our elders, also known as Fangingi. It teaches us to respect our elders and shapes our generations to be more respectful for future generations. Thank you.
Thank you, Naomi.
Next, we have Ha'ani San Nicolas Yuhanyo. Hi, Ha'ani, if you could go to pick a bowl. If you could relive, one moment in your life, what would it be and why? Once more, if you could relive one moment in your life, what would it be and why?
Thank you for that question.
You're welcome.
If I could relive one memory, it would be this moment right now. This journey has taught me a lot of valuable lessons. I've created so many wonderful memories with my beautiful pageant sisters, and we've created so much impact on our community through what we do and what we see. Thank you.
Thank you, Hani.
Thank you. Up next, let's hear from Bernadette Horry. Hi, Bernadette, how are you?
I'm doing well, how are you?
I'm doing great. Oh my God, you guys are so nice. Asking about me and my feelings.
You know, I care about you, Romolo.
Yes, thank you. Even though it's really your month, you still care about us men. We appreciate you. Okay, so please pick from this bowl. Okay, I got this. We're making use of whatever we could. Okay, so here's your question, Bernadette. Describe Saipan, Rota, Tinian, and the Northern Islands in one word and why. One more time. Describe Saipan, Rota, Tinian, and the Northern Islands in one word and why.
Thank you for that question. I would describe Saipan, Tinian, Rota, and our Northern Islands in one word as resilient. From the way we've been able to come back from not one but two super typhoons and now a global pandemic as well. If there was one word to describe the Marianas and her people, it would be resilient. Thank you.
Thank you, Bernadette.
Next, we have Rochelle Tsunami Ramon. How are you feeling, Rochelle?
Hey.
Or you could pick that question for me, girl. Right in that bowl.
Thank you.
Doing some teamwork here. Rochelle, if there was one thing in the world you would cure, what would it be and why? Once more. If there was one thing in the world you would cure, what would it be and why?
Thank you for that question.
You're welcome.
If there was one thing in the world that I would cure, it would definitely be diabetes. Diabetes is a common disease that we have in TMI and in my family especially. I would want to cure my family definitely to live longer, healthier, and happier lives. Thank you.
Thank you, Rochelle.
And lastly, let's hear from Savannah Relox de los Santos. Hi, Savannah, how are you?
Hi, Romolo, I'm doing well. Very excited and happy to be here.
Oh, yeah, I love it. You don't want to ask about me?
Oh, how are you doing?
I'm doing great, I'm excited for you.
Okay, thank
please
you.
Please take from this beautiful bowl. Okay, here we go. Okay, I kind of have to use my mouth again, okay? I'm sorry. Okay, so here we go. Ooh, this is nice. In celebration of International Women's Month, what would you do to choose to challenge help forge a gender equal world? One more time. In celebration of International Women's Month, what would you choose to change to help forge a gender equal world?
Thank you for that question. If I could choose to challenge a certain challenge, I would choose to challenge society in terms of how they examine women. I want them to re-examine how they position women in our society because they are the foundation of our community. Without them, we wouldn't be here. They bring life into this world. They birth all of us. They are the caretakers of our society, and they take care of all of us, especially in terms of COVID. They have been disproportionately affected because many nurses are female, and because they are the caretakers, we have to re-examine their position with it, we have to re-examine how we treat them as women, and we have to take care of them, and we have to evaluate that they give us pretty much everything. Thank you.
Thank you, Savannah. Wow, thank you, ladies, for speaking your truth. It really is difficult to answer a question, especially in front of a live audience and the hundreds of people currently watching live on Facebook. Let's give our other Dream Girls another round of applause. Thank you, ladies, for gracing us with your presence. There you go, another round of applause. Aren't they beautiful?
Well done, ladies.
Beautiful and smart, man, amazing.
Yes.
Nice, okay, so, Yvette, what did you think? How do you think our ladies did in the Q&A competition?
They did amazing. I mean, it's not easy getting up here and answering a question in a couple of seconds, so honestly, can we just give them another round of applause?
Man, for real,
really not that
oh
easy.
My goodness.
And man,
they answered beautifully.
Yes.
Really, really, really nice.
They were graceful and spoke from the heart, yeah. And that's what
okay.
You can ask for.
So, amazing, you competed in Miss USA. What was that like?
Great. I felt like the little girl in me, my dream came true, you know, was something I wanted to do. I remember growing up, my mom and my sisters, we would always watch the Miss USA pageants and all that kind of stuff. So after watching it, you know, I'm like, I want to be on that stage one day. And I did it. So that really kept my drive going. And in my head, there was always that voice, you never know until you try.
Nice. I have to admit, I watched your pageant and I was so excited for you. I felt like a little, that little chubby boy that first watched pageants all over again. I was like, oh my gosh, she's on stage. Hey, thank you so much for representing us. That is an amazing thing.
It was my honor.
Okay. And so, as you were in competing in Miss USA, right? Like, what was that like? What was the process? What did you do to prepare for that?
So preparing for Miss USA was an intense process for sure. I had a team after winning, you know, you go straight to interviews, meaning you go to the local news and you do interviews pretty much all day. Other than that, we had evening gown sponsors, interview coaches, left and right, you know, and just doing workshop within the, how would you say? The directors, they were the ones that were
through
really
your training.
And that's one thing I want to mention because they don't get that much credit as they normally should. And directors have done so much, including with this pageant tonight. And all the volunteers, too, make a big difference. So,
nice. You know, okay, so I have to ask you this one question, though. As a local girl from the Marianas, was there any naughty food you ate?
Oh my gosh.
Or did you completely just go all healthy with that?
That's a good question. You know, I really am a believer of having a balance. So, you know, I do try to stay healthy, but I do like having a little cheat day. So it was really just having a good balance because if you have a cheat day and you go crazy if you've never had one. So.
Oh man, I wish I had a cheat day every day. Yeah. And then maybe I could really fit into that bikini one day.
Oh, yes. Sooner than later, of course.
So as Yvette has mentioned that being a queen is not easy, but luckily Miss Marianas will have a whole team and resources right beside her to make her reign legendary. Here's another message from our amazing sponsors.
first, I was like, maybe I want to go to Hawaii. All my friends are all leaving, you know. Maybe I'm going to stay here. I want to be close to my daughter. I didn't know. It was not clear what I wanted to be.
So I started off taking one class. So I said, I'm going to take one, see how I feel about it. Then if I like it, then I'll do it.
NMC allowed me to experience not just a student of NMC, but a student of the world.
Now the education here is equivalent to what you can find out in the States.
You save a lot of money at the end of the day.
It doesn't matter what age you're in or how long you've been away from class.
When I'm there, I'm totally wearing a different hat. I'm now a student.
My advice is really to find what fuels you, you know, what drives you.
You want to just go out and try it.
Don't stop.
Start at NMC.
NMC is a great first step.
And then eventually you will get to where you would want to be.
That's why it's so rewarding at the end.
Yeah, I wouldn't do it differently.
Wow, thank you to our major sponsors. Come on, Yvette.
I'm coming.
Awesome. So, just how our queen is going to be winning some amazing prizes throughout from tonight, each and every one of you currently present here, you're going to get a chance to win a couple of prizes. Woo-hoo. Hey, why you don't sound excited? Or do you want to win something? Okay, so on your tickets, you're going to see a stub that says a free snack. Congratulations! Oh my
God! That was fast!
You get to eat! We have not eaten! No, I'm just joking. Ladies and gentlemen, four lucky people from tonight are going to win an amazing gift package brought to you by Marpac. So, can we please call up the stellar team?
Yes.
So we can pick team. Our lucky winners.
Yes.
Oh, here we go. Okay, so we're going to take turns of that.
Yes,
right?
Let's do it.
So, our first lucky winner is... Is this box heavy?
No.
Goes to ticket number... 150, Mr. Ben Jr. Fittipole. Congratulations. Okay, Yvette, you want to pick the next winner?
All right, next winner coming up. We got ticket number 166, Emma Sablon, 166.
Ooh, congratulations, Emma. Our third lucky winner is... I can hear the people in the back. Don't worry, I hear you. I'm trying. Ticket number 159. 159, and that is Ricky Itthibus. Congratulations, Ricky Itthibus. And the last one, Yvette.
Last but not least.
Oh, two more.
All right, we got ticket number 102. Ticket number 102. Looks like Sherry, 102. Excuse me, Cheryl Sizemore. There we go.
Wow, congratulations. Where is she, Cheryl?
All right.
Manu, please wave. Okay, yes, thank you. And actually, we have one last final prize brought to you by Marpac. Thank you, Marpac, for serving our amazing raffle prizes and as well those delicious drinks.
You know, also, I like to drink, you know? If anyone wants to buy me a drink, I have great conversations, right? I can make you laugh.
It really does.
And I can give you all the compliments in the world. And the last winner goes to ticket number 135. 135. This belongs to Steve Jang. Steve Jang, congratulations. Thank you, ladies. Nice. Now, Stella Marianas Video Photography Director Jojo Alapuzu, along with Island Image and Motion team, is proud to present the 2021 Miss Marianas official video, highlighting all the amazing activities, events, and trainings our contestants have gone through. Here is their dazzling dream to the crown.
In one word, I would describe the stellar journey as memorable.
My journey to the crown has been extremely eye-opening from all the amazing experiences I've got to go through during this journey.
My journey to the crown was definitely revitalizing.
If I could describe my journey to the crown in one word, it would be amazing.
One word I would describe it is memorable.
Overall, it's been a great experience.
One word that I've used to describe this journey is definitely memorable.
I think no word or words will tantamount or explain my journey to the crown. There are some experiences that just takes you to a whole different level, and it's just a combination of multiple feelings.
One thing I would take away is my self-confidence because of how open I am throughout the girls and just being open with myself.
I take away the memories and friendships that I've made throughout this journey. One takeaway would be time management because I'm always late. I was just late to this one today.
I'm going to take away the incredible friendships I've made during this entire journey. I'm going to take away the woman empowerment and the confidence I've been given throughout this entire thing.
My advice to any person thinking of joining this pageant would be, if you have the slightest bit of interest, do it. Take this opportunity and do the best of your abilities.
To just be yourself and always come as you are and never be afraid to show your true colors.
Win or lose, it's an amazing experience where you gain so many friends and have so many incredible opportunities.
Just take that risk. Honestly, it's so rewarding and it seems so intimidating at first, but you meet so many incredible people. You're able to really just touch the lives of so many individuals and just meet so many beautiful souls in our community. It's worth it.
Able to be a contestant in Miss Marianas has been one of the most amazing opportunities of my entire life.
Prior to this pageant, I really didn't believe in myself, and I didn't think I could do what I could do now, but because of the girls and the amazing team that I have beside me, I've learned to believe in myself, and I'm really proud of who I've become throughout this entire journey.
The most memorable part about being in this year's pageant is being able to share it with the seven other beautiful contestants, and I think they're what got me through until the very end.
I would have to say the most memorable part about this journey would be our trip to the Pika Festival over at Tinian. It was amazing, and being able to connect with our sister islands was such a privilege.
Find me at a club, 'cause if I ever tried to cut a rug, by the time the night is done, you will know that I'm a strange one. I don't ever know what to do, how to find a beat, how to groove, but I dream about finding you. You make me wanna sway, and you'd say, dance with me, not on chum chum. I don't care about where or when, pick a song that never ends. Close your eyes, just move your body. If you only knew what it's like to feel like you have all eyes on every little move you make, you can't seem to find your way. Maybe all this time I've lied, maybe I just never tried. pick a song that never ends. Dance with me, 나랑 춤출래. Close your eyes, just move your body.
Celebrate beauty, celebrate Marianas.
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 Thank you so much.
Motion team for making that amazing video. Our girls truly had a blast throughout this entire journey.
For sure.
But most of all, huge thank you to all our generous sponsors and community partners for making this happen. Let's please give them a round of applause.
And now, let's welcome back on stage Bernice Sabino with her final serenade to the song, A Moment Like This.
Some people wait a lifetime for a moment.
lifetime for a moment like this. A moment like this. Thank you.
Amazing!
Yes, thank you so much.
Wow, thank you, Bernice.
What a great performance.
Again, such a powerful voice.
Yes, oh my goodness.
Wow, for real. Okay, so, ladies and gentlemen, our stage continues to shine as now we'll be announcing the top three for Miss Marianas. Yes. We're getting into that part of the competition. So let's welcome back all our legendary women so we can finally find out who's making it to the top three. Ladies. Let's give them a round of applause. They're a little shy.
Let's go, ladies. They're doing great.
Yeah, they're doing an amazing job. Okay, while we're waiting for that, what are your thoughts on top three? You know, like that's a really critical part of the competition, right?
It really is. And, you know, top three, it's anyone's game. I mean, there are so many great contestants that we have tonight. And, you know, watching backstage, I'm like, good luck, judges.
Yeah, it's definitely,
you have like, the hardest job tonight.
Yeah, as we said earlier, the selection panel definitely has the hardest job because all these women are amazing. Right, they have a lot to contribute, and they have this huge passion for our islands and our people. So definitely, we're excited to see who they think made it.
Absolutely,
right?
Yes.
So again, let's welcome back all our dream girls to find out who is gonna make it to the top three. Please, let's make some noise. They worked so hard to finally get here. Out of eight will be making it into the top three of the Miss Marianas competition. Can we get the official results from our tabulators, BCM? Thank you. Okay, here we go. In no particular order, the first to make it into the top three is Bernadette Horry!
Taking the second spot, Savannah De Los Santos.
And taking the last third spot is Ha'ani Eugenio! Wow, congratulations to our top three ladies. And thank you and congratulations to our other amazing contestants. You all did wonderful tonight.
Yes.
We
great
are
job,
very,
ladies.
Very proud of you. They did so an amazing proud. Job.
It's going to be getting more interesting tonight with the final question and answer portion of the competition. The final question and answer is designed to see Who can think on their feet on a challenging issue and deliver it under 60 seconds?
Yes, 60 seconds to answer that challenging question. One lady will give her answer first, while the other two are covered with noise-canceling earphones. Let's begin with Bernadette Horry. Hi, Bernadette, how are you?
I'm very excited. How are you again?
Yes, congratulations on making it to top three.
Thank you so much.
You got this. Okay, hold on, I'm opening up the question. Okay, we're just gonna verify. The other two are jamming in the back. Okay, so here's your question. I'm gonna repeat it twice, okay? And you have 60 seconds to answer. The question is, if you could choose three colors to paint the Marianas, what would they be and why? Again, if you could choose three colors to paint the Marianas, what would they be and why?
Thank you for that question. If I could choose three colors to paint the Marianas, firstly, I would pick blue for our beautiful oceans where I love to spend time and read. Secondly, I'd choose green for our beautiful lush hills where I love to sit and spend time with my dog, who is my baby. And thirdly, I would like to pick red for the vibrant flame trees that are seasonal, but very beautiful and magical and have a special place in my heart. Thank you.
Thank you, Bernadette. Up next, let's hear from Savannah De Los Santos. She's really enjoying back there.
They got some good music.
Oh, here she is.
Hello.
How are you doing, Savannah?
I'm doing well. I'm very excited again.
Good. We're almost there. So your question for tonight, and I will repeat it twice. You have 60 seconds to respond. If you could choose three colors to paint the Marianas, what would they be and why? Once more, if you could choose three colors to paint the Marianas, what would it be and why?
Thank you for that question.
You're welcome.
If I could choose three colors to represent the Marianas, I would choose three colors that are on our Marianas flag. I would choose blue because it represents the ocean that surrounds us and that keeps us safe. I would choose white because that represents the plumerias, the flower, our national flower. And I would also choose green because we are surrounded by so much greenery. It gives us so much life. Those are the three colors I would choose. I would choose blue, white, and green. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Savannah.
Thank you, Savannah. And lastly, let's hear from Ha'ani Eugenio. Hi, Ha'ani. Hi, Ha'ani, congratulations on making top three.
Thank you so much, Romulo.
Okay, so I'm just curious, like, what song were you listening to back there?
Lizzo, Truth Hurts.
Ooh, and now you're gonna speak your truth, right? Okay, so here's the final question. I'll repeat it twice and you have 60 seconds to answer it,
right.
Okay? So the question is, if you could choose three colors to paint the Marianas, what would they be and why? Again, if you could choose three colors to paint the Marianas, what would they be and why?
Thank you so much for that question. If I could choose three colors to paint the Sinai, I would start off with blue for the beautiful blue oceans. Then I would go with green for our lush green fauna and flora. And then lastly, yellow for the beautiful sunsets that we have. Thank you.
Thank you, Ha'ani Eugenio. Wow, amazing. Yes. Thank you. Beautifully done.
Oh my gosh, the pressure. Our ladies did such an amazing job.
Oh yeah.
The final question.
I felt that intensity. Yeah. And then I was happy that I heard the song that was finally Truth Hurts, and I'm like, it does hurt.
It really does.
it's really hard to choose from those amazing top three. Yeah. So ladies and gentlemen, here for their final performance, dancing to a song of love, where a boy wants to dance with a girl. I want to dance with somebody. Here to dance Kauai, let's welcome to the stage again, Te'ivi Maori. Yvette and I are over here. Maybe we're at center back? I don't know how to say this. Okay, so.
Turn around.
Okay. So, well, Yvette, we just saw our dream girls overcome their fears, especially in the Q&A portion, and then we saw them into the top three. Yvette, who else do you think in this room can answer a question quick on her feet?
Well, a queen, of course.
Yes, and every woman this month is a queen. Woo! So let's have what we like to call questions with the queen. This is gonna be fun, right?
And oh, yes.
Oh my gosh, we found a queen right here. Please, hi, stand up. Hello. So please tell the audience.
Hi, everyone.
What is your name?
My name is.
And what do you do?
My name is Maria Terlahi. You're Miss Northern Marianas Earth.
Ooh, okay, okay. Maria, here is your question. Trust me, super fun, okay? In order to be prepared for a pageant, one needs to eat healthy. What was the first naughty food you ate after winning your crown?
Okay, I have to think. Well, after I got crowned, I went to Naked Fish, you know, the best. Mm. And then I think I had a variation of fish, pasta, burgers, you know, because I was so hungry after the pageant from eating like all that healthy stuff.
Yes.
So yes.
That's awesome.
I had a feast.
What kind of burger?
The Magus burger.
Mm.
That's over there. Try it.
That's Mungi. Nice. Thank you. A round of applause.
You.
Easy, ladies.
Looks like we spot another queen.
Ooh.
Hi, Selene. You want to stand with me real quick? All right, if you can give me your title.
Half a day, everyone. Good evening. My name is Selene Cabrera, and I am the 2018 Miss Northern Marianas. Happy to be here.
Yes, please give a round of applause. All right, I got a fun question for you, Selene. What is the key to a queen's heart?
I actually have 5 answers to that. One is food, 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 and food. My favorite.
Spoken like a true queen. Thank you, Selene.
Nice. So we found another woman who is a queen as well. Hi, stand on up. Come on, come on. So please share with us, what is your name?
Hi, my name is Leigh Tenorio.
Nice. And do you feel like a queen?
I am a queen.
Here we go, okay, yes, here's your question. So your fun question is, what is the one song that makes you feel most like a queen? Want me to repeat it again?
Yeah.
What is the one song that makes you feel most like a queen?
Honestly, anything from Beyonce. I love that musical number, the intermission. Yeah.
Anyone in particular? Like single ladies? Or
Yeah, let's go with that.
Single ladies? You sure? Solid! There's a single lady!
No. Not single.
But a queen.
Yes.
Thank you. Congratulations.
I think we spot another past queen. Make our way over there. You can pronounce your title.
It's from the ancient past.
Once a queen, always a queen.
Oh, my name is Cheryl Sizemore, and I was your Miss Northern Marianas in 1982.
Fun question. If Cinderella was from the Marianas and she left her glass Zori at the ball, would you give it back to her or would you pretend that it's yours?
I truly believe in women empowerment, so I would give it back to her.
Great answer.
Wow, Thank you. Congratulations. Thank you. So we didn't find a Miss Marianas, but we found the Mrs. Marianas. Come on down, stand on up. Hi, welcome. So we're gonna look at that camera over there. We're gonna look towards there. So please tell us, what is your name?
Hafiday, my name is Patty Ogun Cruz.
Ooh, Hafiday, welcome. Okay, so here is your question. Many people believe that kissing a frog will turn you into a queen. Would you kiss the frog? Okay, one more time. Really think on that, huh? Kalaka. Many people believe that kissing a frog would turn you into a queen. Would you kiss the frog?
You never know what's behind that frog, so absolutely, if that's the right frog. Yeah.
Ooh, if that's the frog for you. I don't know if we can call all men frogs, though. Nice. Thank you to all our queens and women for celebrating Women's History Month. You all did an amazing job. And as well, gentlemen, always treat your woman like a queen. So, as one dream is about to begin, another will continue into bigger dreams. Her journey started as a dream. She worked hard to achieve it with passion and love for her islands. An incredible queen who has led us through this pandemic with her grace, her weaving skills, and positivity. She will leave an inspiring legacy. Ladies and gentlemen, for her final walk, here's 2019 Miss Marianas Shannon Tudela Sasamoto.
It has been a journey of a lifetime and a privilege to serve. Being a Girl Scout troop leader and guiding young girls. Organizing food drives to help individuals and organizations through some of the toughest times in history. Promoting initiatives for inclusivity and pride throughout the Marianas. Having the chance to give inspirational remarks to empower others, but most especially to lift up women. Learning from the wisdom of those who have come before me and being equally inspired by others. These are but a few moments I am grateful to have experienced during my time as Queen. I have now worn this crown for 2 years and in the midst of some of the most challenging times in our recent history. When the crown was first placed upon my head, it undoubtedly represented beauty both inside and out. But I made a personal decision that the crown had to mean more. The Miss Marianas crown has transformed into something far greater. This crown represents strength, leadership, inspiration, grace, responsibility, and a deep pride for my people of our beautiful Marianas. I now will treasure and honor these values forever. I would like to thank all the girls and boys that have tried on my crown. You have truly made this crown so much more special to me. Don't ever let anyone, including yourself, set limits upon you. Seduos ma'asi to my stellar president, Michelle Sablon, for helping me through challenges and giving me your genuine support and help. You are the true embodiment of an empowered woman, empowering other women to achieve their dreams. Hiliso to my national director, Jackie Fujihira, for giving me the freedom to be myself and make this reign my own, but also giving me the necessary guidance and support along the way. Thank you for being there for me. Thank you to Jojo Alipuzu and his team for capturing beautiful and amazing moments of this journey. To Michelle Atalik, thank you for being a great role model and photographer who I am grateful for meeting in the duration of my reign. Both of you are not just photographers, but amazing people who truly stand for women empowerment. To Ernie Molina, thank you for teaching me how to walk, speak, and carry myself as a queen. I admire how you never tried to change who I was, only to bring out my true confidence on and off the stage. Overall, thank you, Stellar, and members of the community who helped me in my journey and growth. Lila Boyer, Shirley Sablon, Grace Villena, Bobby Cruz, Valentina Haberman, Frankie Elliptical, and First Lady Diane. Thank you from the bottom of my heart for all those who helped to build me up. To our amazing candidates, thank you for believing in our organization. I admire each and every one of you for your bravery, determination, and individuality. You all have taught me something valuable and have inspired me in many ways. Thank you, Queens. Thank you to all the amazing sponsors and organizations. Your investment in me, belief in the pageant mission, and continued work inspires me to continue to work hard and keep giving back to my community. Thank you to our Miss International Northern Marianas 1995, my mom, for being a great example of what a queen is. Because of the principles, ideals, manners, and determination you have instilled in me, I am able to experience the legacy of following in your footsteps as a queen, and I will continue to make you proud. Todza sinya uma kumpara iguinaiza nana pari patgonya. Hagu ifutsan ilina lahu za hagu muna kabalistu. Nanahu zan rainahu. Huguaizahau. Thank you to my sister, grandparents, dad, and everyone in my family for being there for me and giving me the necessary support throughout my reign. You've taught me to not take life too seriously, enjoy the blessings in the moment, and look on the brighter side of things. Para si tatahu, si Dios maasi puriguinai zamu, zani sapota shonmu niyon extendi para guahu. Para I familiaku, malaguzu para baihu extendi undonkulu zan sinceru na agradecimento por itai finakpu na minasopit mizu. To my successor, I am so excited for you and I'm already proud. I know that you've won for a reason, and now it's time to show the Marianas and the world why that is. You have already gained a stellar sister, and I will support you the whole way through. As I pass this crown to you tonight, I know that you will add a new meaning to this crown that will transform what it means to be a queen. May God grant you the grace to add strength, purpose, and power to the crown. I will continue to celebrate the beauty of being a woman, the lessons learned through difficulties or mistakes, the wisdom obtained through challenges, and most importantly, the beauty in living a genuine and purposeful life. I will continue to celebrate the culture, diversity, strength, and abundance of love the Marianas has to offer. I want to end my reign by reminding everyone of the greatest traits we hold. We are resilient, powerful, and diverse. Para todos hamzu tauta Marianas, y tampoco a la cuenta dos años na tiempo, na mangubetna zu raraina para todos, ningaya na baihu malefa, nui guinaiza, minagov, gentorui momentota. As your Miss Marianas 2019, I am off to work towards another dream, but this is definitely not the last you will see of me. The work continues to do good and bring greatness into whatever I'm a part of and to inspire others to do the same. With great love and gratitude, I am Shannon Tudela Sasamoto, your 2019 Miss Marianas. Undonkulu nasi Dios maasi janhiliso.
I know, she did a great job. All right. Now, if you're all wondering why go through the hard work, determination, immense pressure, and heart-pounding stress, well, here to give you an idea besides the glory of being a queen, here is the 2021 Miss Marianas Major Title and Sponsor video. Thank you. 2021 Miss Marianas title holder will receive trophy and sash, flowers from Island Touch, $3,000 cash from Turnkey Solutions, $3,000 cash from Tan Holdings, Tan Sui Lin Foundation, $1,000 cash from Tresemme, Dickerson & Quinn International Distributors, 1 year use of a brand new 2021 Hyundai Venue from Triple J Motors, an opportunity to compete in the Miss International pageant from Stellar Marianas, 1 year scholarship from Northern Marianas College, title holder portfolio photos by Island Image and Motion, CNMI, a brand new cell phone and 1 year unlimited service and data from ITNE, 1 year membership and personal trainer at Gold's Gym Saipan from Marianas Fitness Limited, 1 year e-subscription to Marianas Variety News and Views, an exclusive product gift set from Tresemme, a four-piece luggage set from Stellar Marianas, a wardrobe set and gifts from Penna House Boutique, 1 year of speech training from Advance, 1 year monthly gift set from Perfectly Posh, 1 year supply of microgreens from Scattered and Sew, 1 year free drinks from Latte Cafe, a gift set from The Athlete's Foot, a gift from Pacifica Insurance, an opportunity to create a community project under your name, assisted by Stellar Marianas.
Wow, the generosity of our major title sponsors is truly inspiring. Thank you to all our titles and major sponsors for supporting our young women and our islands. Ladies and gentlemen, let's please give another round of applause to our amazing sponsors. Truly, our next Miss Marianas is in for
a big treat.
A thrill of a lifetime.
We wouldn't have this prizes for the sponsors, so thank you once again.
Yeah. So Yvette, I am so super excited for this next part of the competition. Actually, not the competition anymore. This part of the show. Ask me why.
Yes. Why? Why are you excited?
It's award ceremony. Because I believe every good deed deserves an award.
I can second that for sure.
Let's do it.
The biggest moment. So yes, Romolo. Now for the evening's biggest moment, the presentation of awards. May we call upon the Stellar Hospitality Team to assist us with the awards.
And as well, can we please call upon again all our dream contestants on stage. Wow, don't they all look stunning? Let's give it another round of applause. So before we announce these awards, we would like to give a special note to the Tan Sui Lin Foundation, where all our girls will be winning an amazing cash winning prizes from tonight. Let's give a round of applause to the Tan Sui Lin Foundation. And here we go. Here is our first award, which is the 2021 Miss Marianas People's Choice Award, in which all of you had voted online at mvariety.com by selecting your best contestant. This lovely lady was voted as to who best represents the Marianas through her spirit of hospitality, beauty, love, and respect for our islands. In addition, she promotes our diverse society and uniqueness to the world. Okay, please hold as I take it out of the envelope. I love this teamwork. And the winner of the Marianas People's Choice Award goes to Tormi Diaz. Here to present this award is IT&E and Dr. Bobby Cruz and Mr. Jonathan Uggen from Edvan.
We have Stellar Star Award. This award is given to the one lady who displayed the largest sense of enthusiasm, commitment, and dedication as a Miss Marianas pageant contestant. This young woman attended all the stellar events, activities, and rehearsals with a smile. She worked hard and had a lot of fun. She represents the best a contestant can be, a stellar star. The Stellar Star Award goes to Vincent Robasto. Here to present this award is Stellar Secretary Victoria Bellis and Coldwell Solar System.
Congratulations. Our next award is from our official hair product of Miss Marianas, Tresemme, brought to you by Dickerson & Q International Distributors. Throughout their journey, the lovely contestants were observed to see who made wonderful use of Tresemme's quality salon products. The 2021 Miss Marianas Tresemme Best Hair Award goes to Vincent Robasto. Here to present this award is the D&Q Distribution and 2019's Best Hair winner, Rianne Capalet.
Was voted on the contestants themselves. This young woman worked well with others and had fun and promoted the qualities of friendship. The 2021 Miss Marianas Friendship Award goes to Savannah De Los Santos. Here to present this award will be from the Lady Diane Torres Foundation and Athlete's Foot. This next award was selected by the island's media members based on beauty, immediate appeal, visual impact, and natural projection. She will receive a model portfolio and professional photographer from Island Image and Motion. the 2021 Miss Marianas Photogenic Award goes to Bernadette Horry. Here to present this award will be Kiki's and Perfectly Posh. Congratulations, Bernadette.
Congratulations, Bernadette. The next award is the Best in National Costume, which is selected on creativity, originality, presentation, and symbolism. The 2021 Best in National Costume goes to Savannah De Los Santos. Here to present this award is Jackie Fujihira from Pow Pow and Lee Tenorio from the board of the Northern Marianas Humanities Council.
The Best in Swimsuit is selected on poise, presentation, overall figure, and physical fitness. The Best in Swimsuit goes to Rochelle Ramon. Here to present this award is Natalie Cruz from Goshen and Julia Espinoso from Island Image and Motion.
Congratulations, Rochelle! Our next award is the Best in Evening Wear. It's selected on poise, presentation, gown, and elegance. The Best in Evening Gown goes to Savannah De Los Santos. Here to present this award is Northern Marianas College President Frankie Elliptico. And Victoria Bellis. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we are down to our final three for Miss Marianas. Could our final three ladies please step forward? And the results are in.
Our second runner-up for Miss Marianas is Ha'ani Eugenio. Here to present this award we have our Stellar Marianas team. And Rianne Capalet, second runner-up, 2019. And Hyatt Regency as well, presenting the award for second runner-up.
Congratulations, Ha'ani. So here's the final moment. We're down to our final two ladies. Ladies and gentlemen, I will be announcing first the name of the winner and then the first runner-up. Again, I will be announcing the name of the winner first and then the first runner-up. So, ladies and gentlemen, one of these ladies for 1 year will represent the Marianas not only in the world's largest pageants, but also in local and regional events as our ambassador. Not to mention, she will win amazing prizes and create memories that will last a lifetime. Now, ladies, one of you is about to become our 2021 Miss Marianas. And if for any reason, the winning Miss Marianas is unable to fulfill her duties, the first runner-up will take her place. And so, our 2021 Miss Marianas is Savannah De Los Santos, which means Bernadette Horry is our first runner-up.
That means our first runner-up is Bernadette Horry.
And Savannah De Los Santos as Miss Marianas.
I think I got it.
Here to present the award for first runner-up is Priscilla Jacopo from NBA. Amir Yunus from Marianas Variety. And 2019 Miss Marianas first runner-up, Sharon Palacios. Can we please call up 2019 Miss Marianas, Shannon Sasamoto? Please come up on stage. Congratulations, Bernadette. And now, our new Miss Marianas, Savannah De Los Santos. Here to crown Savannah is 2019 Miss Marianas, Shannon Sasamoto. Also here to present the awards is Jerry Tan from Tan Holdings and the Tan Shu Lin Foundation. And Billy Grove from Turnkey Solutions. Savannah, now take your first walk as Miss Marianas. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Marianas! And now we will be presenting the perpetual crown made by Momoko Halstead and your sister queen. Congratulations.
Life is like a big merry-go-round. You're up and then down. Going in circles, trying to
And down now, ladies and gentlemen. We will be organizing our photo taking. First, we would like to take photos with the queen and the other contestants, and as well as 2019 Miss Mariana Shannon Sakamoto. Please join in. And then we'll be also organizing later on with the family. So please stay on standby, and as well, please wear a mask when coming up on stage. But you also are welcome to take it off for the photo taking. And now we'd like to call up our stellar team.
Stellar Hospitality team.
For our class photo. Now we'd like to call upon the contestants and their families to come and take a photo in chronological order, and the families of Miss Marianas will do that last. Can we please get the family of Vincent Rabasso, please do come up on stage.
Again, we are going in contestant order.
Yes, we are going in contestant order.
Vincent Rabasso's family, contestant number one. Thank you, everyone, for coming out and showing your support.
Yes.
The volunteers, the sponsors, fans out on Facebook Live watching, thank you so much for all your support.
For the rest of us, again, on behalf of Stellar Marianas, we'd like to thank you all for coming here. Celebrate beauty, celebrate Marianas. And we have a new queen. Thank you and good night. Can we please have Miss Mariana Savannah please come take a photo with Triple J? And then after, we'll do the judges' photo. Yes. So first photo with Triple J, and then a photo with the judges.
people rather say. Some people rather leave the whole wide world than stay. Hey. Miss my favorite people, miss my place. Some people run away, some people guaranteed. Some people love it, but they like to feel new things. Hey. This don't really matter, it's okay. Different view that isn't local or this alone. It's better when together we do more things. Like suddenly I'm moving in my own ways. I knew this all before. I looked at you a different view. I thought I knew for sure. Oh wow. One time, just stay new to you. If the world goes by, I stay new to you. If some girls go by, I stay new to you.